The following is a presentation of the Black Hollywood Live Network, the first online broadcast network dedicated to African-American entertainment. Hollywood redefined. From Los Angeles, California, streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies, this is Black Hollywood Live, The Beat. Featuring the week's roundup and commentary on music news. Black Hollywood Live, Hollywood redefined.
You're listening to Black Hollywood Live.
And now, the host of Black Hollywood Live, The Beat.
Hey, what up, y'all? What it's your up, boy, y'all? DJ Jesse J here in studio. We got our new intro song, Shout Out to CMO. Hey, what? All right, now I'm joined in studio by the one and only Bat DJ Watts.
You see it? We in the building. Let's go.
Where y'all Cameron at, man? Penny.
Yo, there's some hoes in this house.
No, there ain't no hoes in this house. We got HOS in the building. Hearts of Stone. What's going on, y'all? We got Stevie and K Stone.
Yes, sir.
It's good,
thank
man.
You guys for
Happy
joining
to be
me
here.
You guys brought your rocks.
Oh, yeah. Gotta crystals. Get the vibe right, you know.
The vibe came in. The energy came in. All right, so we're going to get into it. But the energy, we need some positive energy because there's been beef going on Twitter, in the music industry. Let's talk about it. So, did y'all see the OVO Fest?
I didn't see it. I seen some of the clips, you know, and I seen the dude getting clipped. You feel me? It was dope.
All right, so Jay, tell us what we got going
man,
on.
Man, I just got four words for the homie Meek Mill, man. Too little, too late. So Meek Mill responded with another diss record out on tour, another diss verse, rather, out on tour, man, but you on your girl's tour, G. I think Drake said it best.
But wait, this came after Drake did the whole meme at the concert situation, right?
You know, Drake's just so calculated from the artwork of back-to-back down to the performance. I mean, even the backdrops, like you said, like the charge up verse to perform it with the phone charging. And then to roast them with the Instagram memes. I think it was just classic. I hope Meek really stacked up his meals because it's getting bad for your boy out here.
I just really want to know what Nikki thinks about all this. Like, what she really is thinking.
I blame Nikki.
I do too, kind of.
I blame Nikki. I blame Meek's whole staff, record label, and everything that's a conglomerate. Nikki should have been down there giving him head and saying, hey, baby, don't put that tape out. His management should have said, don't put that out.
Don't do it.
His record label, Rick Ross, the boss, should have said, don't put that record out. So I'm not blaming Meek.
You're not blaming me.
No, I'm blaming his whole team.
Man,
they failed you, Meek.
Somebody failed you, bro. You gotta pick up the ball. I think for Meek, he just has to fall back, fam. I think he just needs to release a record and he'll be straight, man. Like, leave it alone, bro. It's
like,
done.
He just dropped an album.
Number
Focus
one in the country.
On that.
It's like getting knocked out and then coming back like, nah, we're gonna... Nah.
But number one in the country and then he lost it to Future.
But see, this is the difference. Drake is a student of the game. Drake is studied. Drake will go down one day in history as one of the best artists of all time.
Mm-hmm.
That's why Meek can never go against Drake because Meek doesn't stand on a musical platform. Meek is dope. Streets dope got his boy. Back. I'm all about Meek. I bump his albums, you know, Dreams and Nightmares, but his album was whack. And if you want to go against somebody like Drake, you better bring your A game musically because this was a music battle.
Exactly.
And Meek can't compare.
And legit, like Drake just embarrassed you.
He just embarrassed him.
Three times yeah. before you even dropped a track. What did y'all think of the beef?
I think it's so much more than what the consumer level sees.
Exactly.
You know, I feel like it's a business decision for a purpose. You
for
know?
Everybody.
You know, so I don't know. I don't pay much attention to it.
For real.
Did, and at the end of the day, he's still getting, you know, publicity off of Jay, he just dropped, like you said, he just dropped the album. You know what I'm saying? And for all of this,
all pub
attention,
pub,
yeah, you know what I'm saying.
But I do wonder about the tour though, because I can see Drake obviously has a bigger fan base, and Drake fans being like, "I love Nicki, but I ain't trying to see Meek."
Yeah, man.
I don't know.
See, I don't think all pub is good pub, man.
Like, really?
Well, yeah. I mean, it is. If your name is getting spread, it is good pub. No matter if it's bad or good, you're getting talked about. So your name is in people's ears.
Yeah, but at the same sense, man, at what expense? You know what I'm saying? Do you want to be talked about as that guy that everybody's clowning? You want to be Bozo the Clown out
well,
here?
Well, it's funny you talk about that. So Ja Rule decided to clap at Meek, but then also kind of bring up the relevancy with 50 Cent without him just looking like... So basically, he came out talking about, why are they comparing me? Which one of them is supposed to be me? Hashtag 30 million sold worldwide.
Damn.
Which, all right, we get it, y'all. Like, you was the shit back in the day.
For real.
But then 50 came out and shitted on your career.
But you know what? There was a lot going on with Ja Rule and Murder, Inc. at that time. You know, true. It was indictments.
It was a weak point.
And,
you know what
I'm saying? It was a lot of stuff. But on top of that, Josh is trying to promote his new reality show. He's exactly just trying to get he's trying to get in the PR game right now.
He's smart. Although I am mad about this. So he came out and said whatever, and then 50 came and said something about, like, boy, sit your little punk ass up. And so he posted a picture of 50 Cent on the GQ cover, and he said, if you're comparing us, he said, fucking little punk. He said, this has a lot. This hoe has a lot of balls. She has a pussy. Shut up before somebody put a dick in your mouth. He said that to 50 Cent. That Instagram post is no longer on Ja Rule's page. Man. And I'm just looking like, you had a lot of balls to go say that. Why don't you keep it up if you're going to keep
it
up?
They said you a wankster. But at the end of the day, at the end of the day, we got to remember, though, let's just talk facts for a second, y'all. Let's talk facts. The thing of the difference between the Meek and Drake beef and the Ja Rule and 50 is it got real. It was a street beef that matriculated in the music. You get what I'm saying?
True.
So there was stabbings, there was shootings, so it was a little bit more authentic in that sense. So yeah, we got to respect it from that perspective. And we can't forget that. You get what I'm saying?
Actually, that's probably why Ja Rule deleted it, because he did say, he posted something, if you guys want to compare this to me and 50, someone going to get shot or stabbed.
You get what I'm saying?
Like, let's not put that out there,
we don't need
though
to do that, but, you know.
But truthfully, they should just get in the ring and fight.
Or at least bring Celebrity Deathmatch back.
Ja Rule came out looking swole when he got out the pen.
He did.
So they just need to get my fact fight on Black Hollywood Live.
Exactly.
Did you
right
hear?
Here.
No, we're not promoting that.
Just kidding.
I'll find a sponsor for that.
There you go. All right, but did you hear? You guys check out on Ja Rule's SoundCloud. He did use the publicity to promote his new song, Wake Up. What'd you think of it?
I ain't even heard it yet.
Yeah, it was. It's okay.
It's a positive. It's a positive message. It's not really classic Ja Rule. I think people love Ja Rule.
He's still singing.
Yeah, nah, well, he was rapping.
He was trying to go in. You know, he said some things, but it's just not relevant anymore. It's just like he.
It sounded dated.
That's the key word. It's like, ah, sorry.
Well, speaking of dates, Sierra and Russell Wilson were on a date, and they had Sierra's son with them. He was playing football, and they had little baby Sierra, Future, I guess. What was it, her kid's name?
Future. Little Future.
Little Future. That's what his name going to be. But so he was in Russell's jersey with Russell, and Russell was, like, picking him up and, like, playing with him, and Future was not having it. He was on Twitter, which I'm just like, Future, get off Twitter. Like, come on, y'all, with the damn Twitter.
Twitter thugging, man.
Yeah, so he Twitter thugging him up. And he basically was saying, don't bring people around something that's not permanent.
And permanent.
Twitter went ham in support of Future. Like, Sierra, how dare you bring your kid around this man? Or
all
yada, yada,
thoughts
yada.
Out there.
I'm like, all thoughts. All because thoughts. At the end of the day, here Sierra is trying to like have a good relationship with a man who's acknowledging.
He said,
the
I'm
going
to wait to smash you till we get married. Future smashed her, got her pregnant, and left her.
And pregnant. Isn't that what it was?
This guy said, I'm going to hold off on smashing you. And I'm going to sign this $87 million football deal. And I'm going to bring your son in like he's my son. My son.
Bye.
Come on, y'all haters out there got to stop hating on that.
Hey, that's game, though. No. That's real player
shit. That's real player stuff.
It sound player, but he probably smashing. Like,
honestly,
he probably not.
That shit's
for, like,
better,
when we was playing sports, we wasn't fucking, I mean, we wasn't having sex like that. We kept that energy.
Who?
Yeah, come on,
well,
man.
She probably sucking them off or something.
Like, rumor is that Sierra is like really like apparently when her and Future were together, they would like have sex and then pray afterwards.
I seen that interview.
Russell,
but that's turning her on. I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, you good. Russell seems to be like a good dude. I feel like, man, I kind of side with Future on this one. Like, I'm a father myself, and I don't know. I know it's like a little bit of contrarian. I ain't trying to go tit for tat. I just feel like, man, it should have been a longer period of time before you do it. Like, that's a sensitive thing. And like I said, for me coming of the perspective of being a father, not to say it shouldn't be done, but what time do you bring it in? You got to be sensitive about that.
Okay. It's crazy. You know I'm in that position, though, right now. Like, my girl, I'm in my girl's son's life. Like, you know what I mean? So I don't know how to see it, man, because, you know, it just depends on where she feels like going with this relationship. Right. And she sees it's something like long term, you know what I'm saying? Long as a nigga is, you know, taking care of your kid, respecting your kid while he's in his hands, I
and
mean,
also respecting
it's nothing you could.
Like,
exactly.
Not right. doing the whole like,
exactly.
I'm your
daddy. It shouldn't be
if
no
who can
problem.
Can put a time
that.
On love. If I see somebody and I want
to
love
say.
Them, how can I
exactly.
that was my point. I
hide
was
my feelings.
I can, yeah. You know, I have a son myself, and I don't want to be my baby mother at all. But if somebody want to come in and be the role, I'm still dad all day.
Off top. Yeah.
You know,
off
my
top.
Son live with me. We, you know,
he just
he,
get double gifts.
He coast to coast. Like, another man wants to embrace that. Yeah. It's all good. But what that is that's bitter baby mamas and bitter thoughts on Instagram. Yeah. And sorry ass niggas.
Sorry
who don't
ass
take
baby
care
daddies.
Of, take, yeah, who
weak
like,
as
oh,
fuck.
You had the chance, future.
He still has a chance. It's his kid. Just
but, I'm saying you had a chance to be with her. She's not going back to the trap house after she jumped out the White House.
It's not about here. It's about your kid, and this is the problem: is that he's making it about the relationship versus focusing on
your
job.
Get your kid.
You want to be there at the game, or you don't want him to be at the game? Then take your kid.
Well, he can't really stop the game, but he can say, "Listen, I want
not
the son
stop
more
the game,
with me."
But like, hey, instead of him being at the game, you know what? I want him on that weekend. Like, I'm sure Sierra wants some boo time. You know what I mean? Like,
well, they ain't smashing, so I don't know what they're gonna do.
Well,
just cuddle.
All right, enough of beef. Smacking. Let's talk about something positive: people coming together versus ripping each other apart.
Yes, yes.
What do you got, Jay?
Man, we got Tyler, the Creator, and A$AP Rocky just announced they're doing a joint tour, which is dope because we know A$AP just released his new album, Long Live A$AP.
Yep.
And we know that Tyler just released Cherry Bomb. So, and not to mention they got Danny Brown and Vince Staples as the openers. So I think
that's
this
dope.
Might be,
that's,
you know what I mean?
That's dope as
this
fuck.
Might be one of the like the hardest rap tours of the year. I don't
that's
know what y'all
dope.
Think
that's
about
classic.
It.
That's classic. And they have cult like followings, each of them. They both have cult like societies that follow them. So that's going to be amazing.
Because Tyler's from out here, right?
Yeah, he's from the Dare Heights.
So what blows my mind is that they're only doing this on the East Coast. They're going to do 9-city date tour on the East Coast, starting in Boston, and then they have to probably just, maybe it's like a test. They're going to test out, see how it does, and then bring it over here.
And
but I'm like,
dates.
I feel like the West Coast would fuck with them harder.
Yeah,
than
I sure.
The East Coast.
But I thought they had some beef. But I thought there was some Twitter issues in the past that they had going on. There was certain tweets about, I think A$AP directed Danny Brown's video, Blunt for Blunt.
And, oh, yeah.
And then I think A$AP Ant sent out a Tyler sent out a tweet talking about, oh, everybody using the word video director loosely or something like that. So
well, I'm glad they dropped that beef and they coming together and they bring fan bases together. So that's positive.
Yeah.
All right. So another thing that rumor mill is that Shonda Rhimes might be penning the Aretha Franklin biopic.
Would you?
Man.
So apparently at a party this past weekend, reports are saying that they overheard Aretha Franklin talking with Shonda about Aretha saying to her, basically, I want you to do my biopic. And I would love to have Carrie play my sister, Carrie Washington play her sister.
Okay.
Now, nothing, there's nothing in pen, paper. It's all just allegedly. But that could be kind of dope.
That could be
I know Aretha is really trying hard to have control over her biopic because there are some dark secrets that she don't want to come out. As Miss Patti LaBelle said, it was the church. What did she call it? The church sex mill or something like that. Like there was some.
Yeah, Aretha had like a baby when she was like 16 or something like that.
Man.
But they, you know, they mentioned Jennifer Hudson playing her, but I don't want to see Jennifer Hudson in another singing role.
Is it a musical?
Well, it'll probably be a. I don't think it'll be
like
a musical.
Ray Charles or James Brown type situation.
But yeah, like,
Jennifer might be hot. Jennifer,
I
like Jennifer.
I want to see her another. She plays all the same roles.
Yeah,
like, somebody
knew.
The same
oh,
character.
Yes, yes.
Hey, it was crazy. Holly Berry declined it, right? Holly
yeah,
Berry
she did,
said,
yeah.
I, yeah, she said,
she
I
to
can't.
Play who?
Aretha. Aretha asked for Holly, and Holly's like, I can't sing.
We got to be sensitive, man. Aretha Franklin.
Aretha asked for Holly.
Is the queen.
Yeah,
she asked for Holly.
I'm good.
You Holly look like me.
Like,
she
what?
Said, I need that. Aretha, sit your ass down.
Yeah, sorry.
We're talking about looking like Holly.
Take the L for that one. Sorry.
I love you, Aretha.
Go find a new actress that nobody has met.
That's what I want.
Introduce her.
Yeah, you want to fresh face, man. You know?
Yeah.
You know, she got 18 Grammys. She from Memphis, man. That's 18. Very...
18
Grammys,
she's a queen.
You got to be very, you know, you got to be sensitive with the way we play her. But Holly, she tried it, didn't she?
Sorry.
She tried
she
it.
Don't
she
got the pipes.
Yeah.
Jamie Foxx was real good at Ray Charles because he could actually play the piano and he could actually
top.
Sing. So,
Ray
but made the role room or
Jamie
Foxx
is a hell of a...
That's why Jennifer crazy. Will be hot because Aretha's the only one with that voice.
Yeah.
Or Fantasia.
Okay, I would like to.
I'd rather see Fantasia.
I would rather, but she, I wouldn't cast her. But I would rather see somebody. I just don't want to see Jennifer Hudson in that role. Go find somebody on Broadway.
Honestly, for Jennifer Hudson, I don't want her to do it because she gets stuck in that. She would get stuck in that category, and that's more for Jennifer Hudson.
Definitely.
All right, but. Speaking of legends, Aaliyah's fan base is going ham right now. I don't know where the hell this came from, why all of a sudden. Oh, because of the Selena.
Yeah.
So Mac did the special thing with Selena.
Mac
and
who?
Now Mac Cosmetics.
Okay.
So
okay.
Basically now Aaliyah's fan base came out and started this petition in which they want Aaliyah for Mac. So her brother came out and he said, you know, she loved Mac. He named whatever specific. I was like, y'all just marketing the hell out of this. I think this was all kind of a plot from her team.
Her team.
Kind of like, let's keep Aaliyah, which is good, though. I think it would be a dope situation. It would be a nice little, just a little collection real quick for the, they should wait to do it around like February, around her birthday and release it. I think that would be cool.
I agree. I think it's great marketing. I think it's good PR. You know, Selena's fan base went after Mac to get to Selena cosmetic line. They signed off on it. And Aaliyah was baby girl. You know, Missy retweeted it out. And the point I was about to make about Aaliyah is, like, they keep Marilyn Monroe alive. They keep Elvis Presley alive and keep figuring out ways to rebrand them. So I think this is very smart, and I'm sure that people will buy it.
And especially with, like, N.W.A., Straight Outta Compton coming out. Yeah. It's like all these 90s stuff is coming back around. And the colors that they specifically want to use, it's those Aaliyah, like, staples. Right. That lip, that brown lip, the dark tint, like, the dark shadow eyes.
Aaliyah,
you know, I think just to bring that kind of an idol back is really dope for music. What do you guys think?
I agree.
Yeah, I fuck with it. That's heavy.
Yeah, I'll buy it for my girl for sure.
They doing dancing games with Michael Jackson, bringing him game, bringing him back. So why not Aaliyah get her fame back?
Yeah. Why did they never do, what was that dance? What was that dance game that everyone was on? Was it Dance Revolution?
DDR,
yeah. Remember, and they came out with Michael Jackson. That would have been really dope. I'd be my brother. Be
but
like,
they had one for the Wii. Just Dance just with dance, Michael Jackson. Yeah.
That's what it is. Yeah. They should have done one with Aaliyah because that would have been so dope.
They probably was hot because they tore that movie up with Aaliyah.
That Aaliyah movie was terrible.
The funniest thing about that was those memes. All those memes when they had everybody playing and all those characters. That was hilarious. But you know what was wrong with the throwback pick was the girl. She never had no penis. Like, you can see Aaliyah's had swag. R. Kelly broke her in young. So when she made moves and she did things, she had certain sex appeal.
Oh, yeah. She had
to. She was too stiff.
That's
real stuff. No weenie. No weenie. She was too stiff. Like, come on, man.
They say Zendaya dropped out of that role because she didn't like how it was handled.
Well, they probably didn't. She probably didn't want to get outed at the fact that she'd been getting knocked down. All right, speaking of what the fuck moments, so Lenny Kravitz had one.
Speaking of weenie,
Lenny Kravitz had one. You guys heard about this?
No.
Hashtag Penisgate. All right, so basically. Lenny Kravitz created
this.
So Lenny Kravitz was performing, and we all know Lenny has his outfit of choice. It's them tight painted on pants with the jacket and his little tank top. So he's performing. He goes down and bends down. As he bends down seamlessly, no pun intended, his pants rip and London Bridge came falling down.
No draws?
Sometimes you just gotta, you gotta give them something to look at, man. And let them know that it's witness.
Dude, but the way it came out, it's just like, you really had that tuck. Like,
what if it was planned?
I mean, part of me thinks it probably was planned because why everyone's so excited about this is finally they're saying, it's always like a wardrobe malfunction with females, and now the girls are excited. And of course, he's a sex idol to females, so it's like
it was
out of everyone for it to happen. Like Lenny Kravitz.
Lenny Kravitz is a rock star. Purposely. And that was a rock star movie.
Yeah, like, no draws.
Yeah,
no draws.
And it was pierced or something, right?
It was pierced.
It was pierced.
So we found. I didn't realize it was pierced.
No, he had a ring on it. That's what it was. It was a ring.
He had a ring on his Jimmy.
The reason was because. Steven Tyler texted him and was like, what the fuck? Your shit's pierced and you never told me about it?
Uh-oh.
And I'm like, well, what the
suspect.
Fuck are y'all?
Man. That's crazy.
Why?
Lenny, I need another shot.
What happened?
Right. So, all right, Lenny, that's you. You got publicity out from your dick. There you go. All right, let's talk about some new music. We got Christian, Bedroom Part 2. Jay, where'd you find this?
This is Christian, man. He's a dope artist. He signed to Warner Chappell as a writer, but he's also a singer and producer. He produced the record 2 a.m. But, man, this kid is real talented out of Minnesota, man. This is my bro. I've been rocking him for a long time. Y'all check him out. Tell me what y'all
think. So we're going to play a clip, and then you guys let us know what you think after.
Okay.
Christian.
Stop touching me, baby. No love for me, baby. No love in that name. But shit just got stranger. Ever since I bought my Ranger, these bitches acting crazy. These bitches say they real. These bitches ain't for real. These bitches ain't to be trusted. They ain't cool with my mother. They say I'm out of line. They don't know what it's like to give a bitch your life. To trust her like a wife. 1 minute they're your girlfriend, next minute got a husband. I thought that was your cousin. You know good motherfucker. They love to see you struggling. Always
come back when you Christian Bedroom Part 2. Yeah. What y'all thinking?
He must have just got his heart hurt.
That nigga said, don't touch me.
He hurt right now.
He hurt, man. That's just kind of hot, though. I like the video.
You can see he was listening to Drake all night. Yeah. Like, okay, Jay. You know, I saw a Drake prototype over there. So if I'm an A&R, I'm going to say, you know what, here. You know, go back over there and create your own image.
I fuck with it.
It's cool.
Yeah, I like it. I like it. Yeah.
All right,
I knock anyone's artistry.
Well, sometimes we have to.
It's not knocking the artistry, it's knocking the lane. So it's like, okay. I heard the lyric, I heard the harmony, I like the beat, but it's already a lane. So,
but Drake ain't doing those ballads right now.
But Drake is the master of that.
Like,
he's
in the meantime, we need that.
He got body by a singing nigga.
Yeah. Basically, he's a little bit more R&B, man. Like, so
he is more R&B. He's more of a
singer. I love the lyrics. I mean, there was a harmony in there, but I'm just saying, I've seen it.
Drake be singing.
Like, sometimes Drake, you know, hey, Drake, you look for more Ghost Riders.
Quentin Miller.
Yeah, I want to see it.
All right, so I put this in because randomly someone sent this to my email, and I was like, let's see what it is. And normally I don't like to play the typical shit, but I found myself in my bedroom vacuuming and jamming out to this song. I do what we call what Snoop Dogg says. He said, every song out here make you want to do this.
Bounce.
Bounce. Bounce, bounce, bounce.
So
bounce.
This is Cool America. It's called Make Some Shake.
Aight.
Oh, no, this is not. This is going to be
August Alsina
hip hop. That's fine. We're going to play this one first. Play August Alsina hip hop.
Only 4 years old when Biggie got shot. I remember playing on the block, hanging on the block. Young niggas slinging on the block, getting off the rock. Now we living better now. Coogee sweater now. Change the weather now. Came up in criminal days, living these criminal ways. What can I say? Hugging the block every day, grinding and making a way. And that I pray for better days, that it don't be the same tomorrow. Now I celebrate my sorrows with this bottle. Insane.
Hip hop, hey. Hip hop, hey.
I pray for more better days.
Hip hop, hey. Hip
hop, hey. I know that I can feel change.
August Alsina hip hop, what you guys thinking?
That was hot.
How do you guys feel about August Alsina's career? Like, as far as like, because he made a big noise when he first came out, and then I feel like he's kind of died down a little bit. And I feel like him and Trey Songz together, like that lane has just kind of been closed off now.
I think it's cool because his story, I like the New Orleans and moving to Houston and blowing up out there in the South. I was kind of in Houston during the time it was happening, so I was witnessing the come up. So I liked it as a fan perspective with the new hip hop R&B sound, you know. I like him. I'm a fan of him.
I like it. I always fucked with him because of the trap in the R&B shit. That's something I'm cool with. Like, you know what I mean? Like, long as it's like a good artist, you know what I'm saying, got a cool little story, I'm with it. You know, I'm all for it.
I didn't like the fake cry on the BET Best Artist. That's what got like, oh, you gonna fake cry. Like, it wasn't sincere.
What you thinking?
I didn't like his shoes that he wore to the red carpet. First of all. But you know what? August Alsina is dope.
Yeah,
he is talented. Whoever his stylist was, you know, to give the overall when he was from the 90s.
Do you like that?
That's how we used to rock it.
I'm probably going to be in that.
That was my high school days. But one thing I will say is he is stuck. Somebody, his team, his management, his A&R, they need to give him that record that's going to cross him over. Like Say I did for Trey Songz when Trey Songz was in that one area he was trying to break out. So that's where August, but one thing about him.
They tried it with that Nicki track.
I love vagina, but he is a good-looking guy, and the females love him death.
Yeah, they love him, man. I think August is definitely needed in the game right now because he comes with a level of authenticity I feel like the game is missing.
Some realness.
So, you know what I mean? Like, from his brother getting shot, and his backstory is just crazy. Mm-hmm. So I think he's good for R&B. I think he's good for music, man. And he's fly. But, you know.
You need a record. You need that crossover
record. Really does, because my thing is, like, this one was really dope because when the song first starts out, it was typical at August, and I was just like, because I can't, if every single song that you putting out has, you know what I mean? Like, it's dope for like three of the songs, but when it's like every single track you putting out is that. But then he flips up with the flow, and I've never heard him do what he did in this song if you listen to the full thing. And I can appreciate that, and that for me shows that, okay, you're listening to what people are saying, you're trying to grow, and he just needs someone to give him that track.
Yeah, he needed to create that crossover record.
But they tried it with Nicki, and it didn't work. So I think he's going to have to, like, I would like to see him do something with maybe, like, a newcomer like that Natalie LaRose. Something like that would be kind of cool.
Shout out Jess.
He's with Def Jam. They're five, and he's still young. He's still growing. He's still learning. But he definitely has a loyal fan base to the point where when he do drop the record, they'll support it. Boom. But he got to get on Ryan Seacrest, and he got to do the crossover.
Yeah, he got to pull some Trey Songz stunts.
There you go.
All right, so here we go. This is Cool America, Make Some Shake. Just ratch. Love it.
Send a play my way, I bet I made some shape. Cause I'm here my line, he said let me some shape. I'm on my left 2K, I bet I made some shape. Milking niggas for that cat, bet I made some shape. Roll running, made 10K, that was yesterday. Pull one more and I'll be straight, make sure my young is 8. Roll up spike, got 40, stole me 40 jewels today. Sir, simple Miss Codeine with a chocolate shake. Pop a perk and smoke a O, I still can make it shake.
Alright, so Cool America, I'm gonna say this about this song. I feel like, cause there were, for a while as a DJ, I listened to these songs and I'd be like, so irritated when people are coming up to me like, can you play? I'm like, who the fuck is that? Like, every week it's some new song. It's like, you ain't heard Turn It Up? Oh, you ain't heard Shake It Down? You ain't heard
Stanky Leg?
Right, like, you know what I mean? Like, we have staples, you know? So I think that this is where we are with music. I feel like, in hip-hop, we're gonna have to have these people who are just dropping shit on a weekly basis, and that's what it is. If you can drop a hot single and then come up with that follow-up single, then you can stay in the game. Mm-hmm. Because most of these people, they come up with the first single and it's fucking dope, but there's no follow-up because they weren't even expecting for that first single to really pop up. They was just like, no, we was just in the studio with my boy and we did this. Like, when I Watch Me Whip, do that, nay, nay. They wasn't ready for that video. That song had came out a year, and then all of a sudden they dropped the video 2 months ago. Like, no one's even listened to that song no more.
Yeah.
You know? Or like, I would talk about, again, Boss Ass Bitch. That song was so hot for a whole year. The only reason it got resurrected was because of Nicki Minaj.
Yeah.
So, it's interesting, in 2015, my favorite saying, where we are with music. So what do you guys think, a song like this,
I take it.
In the ways of, well, why would you, okay, to from an A&R perspective, why would you take it?
I mean, because it's the format. And it's the lifestyle, and it's the sound of right now. So
sure.
I'm just looking.
But are you just taking the song, or are you looking at the artist? Because
I'm taking the song, But I would definitely, okay, but we got a good song. Now let's try to come out to Cali or New York, and let's try to get a good, stronger follow-up with a Mustard or Ty Dolla $ign and try to get the branding. But they got her club banger.
Mm-hmm.
They're right now, yeah, without anybody, they're getting booked Thursday through Sunday.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Yeah. They're getting some spin. So now my job will be able to come in and to give them a longer lifespan and create some more revenue streams for them. So I like that song for the fact that it sells.
Yeah, shout out to the club.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, I'm big in the events. You know, I do like the hottest events in LA, and just kind of touching on what Cameron said, I think it fits the club space. Like, when it comes to the club space, that's gonna make people dance. It's gonna make them move.
You bring them in,
they're gonna turn up, they're gonna have a good time. Yeah, I do the booking and just throw the event. So, you know, from my perspective, I'm looking at it like, people want to hear that type of shit.
But
they
do record labels,
you know,
do you guys think record labels take that seriously? Because we, after our conversation last week, it was like everybody keeps finding these YouTube kind of like stars where it's like they have one hot song, but there's no actually branding as far as like sitting and working with artist development.
Well, everybody wants ends on it. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. So if the shit is buzzing, like, it's going to be like, you know, let me, what can I do to help? You know what I'm saying? They'll help and get everything
get
going.
Get their dollars.
Get their dollars. That's it.
Record labels not caring about true artistry no more. They just want that money. They want to put people in debt. They want to take the song to the next level to have you in debt.
That's why it's very important for the artists and the team to do as much as they can possibly on their own.
Yes.
And then you
get a good team. Don't have cousins and uncles and shit
you
like
get
that.
A good team.
You need a team.
Yes. You get a good team and you can do so much without a record label. Or when it's time to negotiate, you can get the best possible deal
at
that time.
All right. Hearts of Stone.
Yeah. It's some hoes in this house. It's some hoes in this house.
Let's just reference why he keeps singing this song. Because you guys go by H-O-S.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Okay, so, and apparently Cameron looks at that.
I think it was Mr. Doe.
But it is hoes. I mean, it's any way you perceive it.
Yeah. So where did the heart, I mean, you guys obviously have stones around your neck. So where did Hearts of Stone come from?
Well, my name is Stevie Hearts.
And I'm K-Stone.
And he's K-Stone. So Hearts of Stone.
Oh, that's dope.
It's both of our names together, and then we're both solid to the core.
And you guys have worked separately as independent artists, and what made you guys kind of bridge together?
We made each other hot.
The song.
That's it. That's all it was. Yeah, the song.
The song came together and was like, oh my God.
And what's the name of the song?
Well, the first song that we did, it's not out. It's called CTS. It's on the album that's coming, like, 2016. And we've been best friends since kindergarten. Playing like football brothers. And brothers since
who
I spent
lost their virginity first?
That's what we gotta know.
I think I did.
The ladies
I think
Michelle
I did.
He
was a little early bloomer.
Real fresh and, you know.
Early bloomer.
I had an older chick. Yeah, I was a senior.
He was getting it in. He was getting it in.
But he, you know, he more cool than that. He turned up.
I turned all the way up.
He blossomed on the young.
So you guys are from California.
Yeah, Compton, to be exact.
Delamo.
All right.
I grew up in Delamo with him, though.
Which is like 5 minutes
closer. Yeah, it's like straight down
Central.
It's the
Hollywood
of
Compton. Yeah. The two-story houses.
And now, where did the music come from as far as like what you wanted Hearts of Stone to sound like?
We didn't have an idea, but once we start doing music together, the Hearts of Stone sound came to us.
Hmm.
The sound showed us, like, this is y'all sound.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we just rocked with it.
We just did more songs on that sound.
I want to play a clip. You guys can keep talking about it. But so, Mr. Get Dough. Alexis, you have that? Alexis?
Hey, bro. Boom.
Tell us about Mr. Get Dough.
This is a song that's out that DJ Mustard produced, you know, so we just wanted to, one of the homies did it, so we just wanted to do our own re-edition.
Shout out to DJ Marshman.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Marshman, DJ Marshman,
Crash D.
Hearts of Stone, bitches, H-O-S. Don't you start with stoner, I will take your neck. Don't make me bark this chrome while I trace your steps. And I'ma mark you gone while I take your check. I love a woman, but it's fuck a bitch. You know you putting shit down when she gotta call you by your government. It's been a hard 20 years, but motherfucker, I'm loving it. Me and Steve let the real be known, they never gotta cover shit. Stone. Mr. Get Dough, 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 Mr. Get Dough. Mr. Get Dough,
say y'all
Mr.
Get Dough, put your
Mr. Get Dough, Mr. Get Dough, Mr. Get Dough, Mr. Get Dough. Hearts of Stone and H.O.S., but we both some hoes. So call the zone, we play the best, yeah, we coach them hoes. So start the song, they obsessed, cause we on the flow and bark the throne in the west.
Hearts of Stone, Mr. Get Dough. All right, so that one's already out, right?
Yeah, that's already out.
And, Now, you have this song. This is actually where I first had heard of you. I was actually the creator of our theme song, Miss Sia Amun. That is your brother, your sister.
My sister, yeah, my blessed sister.
And I was at her studio, and all of a sudden the song came on. I was like, who's this? And she's like, that's my brother. And so Work On You, tell us about that.
Well, Work On You is featuring Davion Ferris. That's who's singing the hook. Shout out to him. He got 7 songs on Tyrese's number one album right now in like 16 countries. He's singing the hook. And, you know, me and Stone came up with the concept. And we just, you know.
And you guys have a dance to this one?
Yeah, we do have a dance called the H.O. It's our dance. It's not the song that has a step. It's our step.
Oh, you guys have a step.
But this is the first
step. Which I have to say. So we had a Black Hollywood event. And you was there, Stevie. And Stevie B... One thing as a DJ I can't stand is like when you know you playing the songs everyone want to hear and everyone just want to be out in L.A. I don't know why no one want to dance in L.A.
People bougie, just like, man. People too good today.
Go down to Atlanta.
Not Stevie.
He in the middle.
Steven's I'm a Compton baby though.
For real, man.
So how does the dance go?
You want me to stand up?
Y'all gotta hit it for us. Y'all gotta
yeah.
stand up.
Go ahead. Put the camera on them. The I'm gonna zoom out so we can get you on the camera.
So take the headphones off.
Yep. Go ahead.
Song, but oh, you can play it. Let me work on you. I'm a little mama, let me work on you. I'm the type to show you, give it to you like how you come. A little mama, let me work on you. Let daddy see how that body move. And I don't need to pop a pill to be a naughty dude. You can even bring your friend, cause she a hottie too. And I'm gonna show the book the arm with the shoddy do. Turn the thing on your new bus, smoke on this reef. You can come and stay with me with your nigga, Lisa. Yeah, I love that.
Hearts of stone, baby.
Brody, I was responsible for the dance part. Stone didn't get into dancing until we became a group. I made him dance.
Yeah. For real.
So he was the dancer.
Never.
Well, your energy just, it made me want to get up and dance. When you was on that dance floor the other day,
appreciate
I was like,
you.
Shit, I'm going to get out there. Like,
you had me going. Jesse J had the tunes going hard, though.
Oh, real.
Boom. Okay, so Work On You featuring Davion. Shout out to Davion. All right, now you guys said you had brought us a little world premiere situation.
Yeah, we got a song we pretty like. We like, you know?
I love this song, guys.
Okay. It's our favorite song.
I think it's the best.
We ain't put it out yet. And you know, I wanted to, you show me love. I wanted to show you love and bring you our best works for you to, you know, show.
So tell us about it. Why is it your favorite out of everything you've already recorded?
Well, for me, at per se, you know, we got offered a deal by some, you know, people that are in the industry and are respected and stuff. And the way that it went down, it was just like kind of shiesty to me. So the whole situation of us not signing
in the music industry.
What?
Shiesty. So us not signing the deal and all the emotions that was like, you know, within the situation, because they had the key to the gate. They could have pressed a button on us, you know.
That shit hurt.
Know that somebody can press a button and you don't go through with it, and then you see it happen after you're removed. It's like, so this song really, we got to express those feelings, you know?
That's good.
And so what's the name of the song?
Get Rich.
It's another freestyle, actually.
Yeah, this is a song that's already out. We just did our rendition.
So why did you specifically pick this beat?
It's so classic. It got that Dr. Dre, What's My Name, bass line, you know, with the new school, you know, synths and stuff. I love it.
All right, so here we go. Hearts of Stone.
Get Rich.
I would never take a low ball when your best player's leaving. Would you even had a show off? Motherfucker, I am starving as fuck. I need some money up front, and I ain't taking no more L's. I had plenty of them. We ain't gasping for nowhere. You ain't choking us. Me and Steven package deal. You gotta take the both of us. Respect and loyalty is what a nigga breathe.
This is your song right
punks,
here.
You old play gun niggas, and when it comes to being a man, I'ma stand up. Probably see we too hot and trying to fan us. I need a lifestyle change before I sign a deal. I need my fresh loaf of bread right behind the meal. Got this 1882 that I'm smoking on, with a bad brown skin that I'm working on. Let me work on you is a favorite song. She get to shaking that ass in her favorite thong. She got to feeling herself when it first came on. And if it ain't enough money, bet I won't stay long. So you.
All right.
right, Get Rich. So when is that going to drop for everybody now? I mean, it got to come out now because everyone watching is going to be like, where the fuck do I go get that?
Not yet. We no. wanted to even want when wanted more. We got a video dropping to this one. We shot the video, you know, at the rooftop little spot. Nice little video coming.
So you guys said your album, you're going to drop it in 2016. Is it an album? Is it a mixtape? EP? Like, what are we
going to do? It's actually a miniature album. It's two sides.
It's a two-side miniature album. Side A and side B, both around 8-7 songs each.
Okay.
But it's one album.
And what's with the two sides? Is it one little more heart, one a little more stone?
Most definitely. One is heart and one
is stone. Yeah, that's basically what it is. All the songs... The concepts he came up with is on his tape. The concepts I came up with is on my tape.
Yeah. And then we're gifting to each other. Like, we're 7 days apart in birth.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so one is going to be from me to him, and one's going to be from him to me.
So it's almost like a little outcast situation, a little speaker box love below, kind of.
Yeah, similar.
Just heart of stone.
A little similar. Yeah.
Boom. All right, so... As far as working together, what's the process like? You get one hears a beat. Is one more into the beat production part of it? Is one more into the writing part of it? You guys hear a song. How do you come up with the concept for the song?
Well, we both write and we both produce. So, I mean, it's a million ways it happens. Sometimes he has a complete hook song, a whole song done, and he just might want me to sing a part. And when I sing it, it come out dope. I might have a whole song done, and I want him to rap a verse and come out dope. We might be in the studio together and like come with just it come together. With
it's just a click thing. Like, yeah, it's never like it's. I don't know. And I'm not. Effortless. Let me not say. Now I don't want to, you know, put anything. But it's just like. It just happens, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, just like he said, it'll be a verse or, you know, just a whole song. Like, you know, you need to do something to this. He'll send me the beat and it'll just be something. Everything I clicked with through this whole, how many 50 to 100 songs we got, like, it's everything I've clicked with. It's never been a problem.
And never. Then as far as the stones, the rocks, the crystals, like, I mean, obviously in hip-hop, you mostly get gold chains and that's what people are focused on. You guys are coming out with crystals. I'm a crystal person myself.
Okay.
Where did this come from? You know, I mean, you rocking a lot of them right here. I mean, you must get questioned all the time, like, what the fuck you got around your neck?
The Jesus piece.
Well, it's my brand. It's called Rocks by Stevie. You know, I'm really big into enlightenment. I've been a student of light, I would say, and right knowledge since I would say about 8 years old. I've been following and on the path, a journey of knowledge, you know. So I've always wanted to integrate light and get it to everybody. And what better way to do it than fashion, you know, to get people conscious and get their mind, that third eye open through style.
With you guys growing up in the Comptondale other area, so many influences coming out from the game to, you know, the new movie is out. What was your experience like growing up in such a city like that?
Well, you know, we didn't see it at all.
Yeah, it's been a little bit of everything.
You could have went either way, but you guys seem like you got your head on right, and you're more focused into
playing football.
Okay. It was sports. Like, you know what I mean? It came till I want to say high school. Like a little, like after high school is when everything was like on us. So it's time to make our own choices and, you know, stuff like it was like that 11th grade year, but we still had to go to school, but we still went to play football. So, you know, we had to have our grades and stuff right. But once we got out of, you know, school, he still went to school.
Yeah, I got a scholarship.
Nice.
And just after that, it was just all on our own choice. So music was a thing I was always into, you know what I'm saying? But never really, I'm not going to say that I didn't get to pursue it because of my parents. You know what I'm saying? It was sports. It was just sports, you know, and that's just how that got, you know what I'm saying? Me being at his house a lot, you know what I'm saying?
Always had studio.
Always. Because of my father. So it's something I was always messing with. Like, you know what I'm saying? I always wanted to mess around with a beat and wanted to record myself, hear myself, stuff like that. So it was something I was always into. And always.
Stevie, I mean, let's talk about your father from the group Troop.
Yeah. I knew that was, oh my gosh! I was getting ready to say, is your dad, he wore the Michael
Stevie
Jackson
Russell
glove
last year.
I was at the BET Awards with Silk. No, for real.
I was there too, yeah.
I was there because they did the tribute because I was working with Silk.
Oh, okay.
And he was all back there and he had the glove on. And then, I was getting ready to say, is that, you know, he dad wrote for Trey Songz and
everybody.
And your sister, too. I mean, so you come from a very musical family.
Yeah, but they all pushed me to sports.
I was about to say, that's
really?
That guy.
Yeah.
Because I was going to say, how do you find your own artistry when it's like...
That's crazy.
You know, yeah. I just saw Straight Outta Compton. So for me, with that, watching Ice Cube's son in the movie, it was like, how do you find your own self when... Your father has already kind of put such a staple of, like, who this family is, what this is, and how do you find, how was that difficult for you, or was it kind of like, nah, man, I was fucking picking rocks up? And
well, luckily for me, my dad always, I was very, very pushed to be confident. Mm. Confidence was a household lesson. He didn't want me insecure in any kind of way, so he has given me this divine sense of self-assurance, you know what I mean? So once I was in school and I wasn't liking the football and I found out that I could rap, you know, my sister was writing and stuff, so I came home and she had me in sessions at Tyrese's house as my first writing sessions. And wow, I was good. Everybody was like, oh, that's dope. So I'm like, oh, I can do this, like, this easy. I'm 18 years old at the time, you know what I mean? So I'm like, I left school, you know, did the music thing, dropped a couple mixtapes by myself, and then me and my best friend linked up, and it's been all since then. It's only been a year and a half since I've been doing music.
Wow. That's what's up, man. Hey, yo, who y'all are? I was curious listening to y'all speak, man. It's dope. Who are the influences, though, man? What's your influences? Like, who influences y'all?
Mine would be Cole, Drake, Jay-Z, Pac, Nip, and Outkast.
And mine would be Kanye West, Kendrick Lamar, Heatwave, Michael Jackson.
That's so funny. I can see it.
Like, exactly. We all just said it.
He said Heatwave. Yeah. Representing Ohio. Shout out to Ohio out there.
Yeah. You know, everything. You just do everything. Okay, so we have a new album coming out, a double disc, double-sided 2016. Do we have a kind of date? Do we have a name? Do we have, like, an idea of where we're taking the album?
It's Hearts of Stone, a miniature album, side A, side B. But more importantly, we working on a movie right now.
Work on the movie.
The song has a movie. You know, we're taking some. We having a soundtrack for the movie. You know, in pre-production right now.
Directed by Crash D. Man,
Crash D. He's out there.
Now, why did the song inspire the movie? Did the movie inspire the song?
Well,
is this something new that we're going to start getting, and maybe you guys are going to start something new?
The process happened, like, I had an idea for the video.
Yeah.
And I took it to Crash because I knew he was going to, you know, he's been working in the industry so long, so I needed some help. And he was like, nah, like, this concept is more than a video.
Yeah.
Like, this is a movie. So Jess came along and some other people, Martha, a couple of people on the team, they just start working on the script and adding more scenes and, you know, expanding on the script. And I kind of took that, like, I usually want to be like, ooh, I do this, but I just kind of sat back in the artistry role and let them have it, you know, and it's coming together, you know. So pre-orders is starting next week for the movie. It's we're actually gonna have a premiere, a show, and a listening party for the album.
Nice.
with the pre-order ticket, you know?
Oh, you already know the beat gonna be up in that. So where can everyone follow you guys and keep up to date with everything you guys are dropping?
Well, the Instagram is k.stonehos, the Twitter is kstonehos, Snapchat is Stones World, and that's it. And the SoundCloud is Hearts of Stone -1.
And me is Stevie Hearts, STEVIEHEARTS, on Twitter and Instagram and Snapchat, Bathing Stevie, like Bathing Ape, but Bathing Stevie. And SoundCloud, Hearts of Stone -1.
And are we getting to work on you? Well, we're going to get the work on you movie, but when is that going to actually drop?
We're planning for, like, fall. September, October.
Fall type, okay. Yeah. So
not too far.
Not too far. But we got some videos dropping in the meantime for Mr. Get Know and Get Rich.
Perfect.
Yeah.
All right, so make sure you guys check them out. Cameron, where can everyone find you?
Find me with these guys. Movies, hanging out with y'all.
Yeah.
All of that stuff. Yeah. So now you can find me on Twitter. You can find me here on Thursdays. I mean, what today? Friday?
Get your fucking, let's just say your fucking Twitter.
The alcohol is starting to kick in. 29 minutes. And I'm starting to fulfill it. That's why I got quiet for the last 20 minutes, like, stuck. Just follow me on Twitter at CameronPenny_, but everything is at CameronPenny.com.
Jake?
You can follow me at That Dude J Watts, spelled THATDUDEJ, the letter Watts, like the city, WATTS, on all social media. Follow me, ladies.
Boom.
Gentlemen.
Make sure you guys hit me up at DJ Jesse J. Also, make sure you guys hit us up at BHL Online and The Beat TV on Instagram. Please subscribe to us down below. And then I need your help, y'all. I need y'all to head over to iTunes, type in The Beat BHL, and subscribe. Leave us a comment. If you leave us a comment, I'm going to give you a shout out. Till next week, same time, same place. Peace.
Peace. From executives Kevin Undergaro, Dario Kristen, Tiana Hobson, and the entire BHL staff, we would like to thank you for supporting Black Hollywood Live, the first online broadcast network dedicated to African-American entertainment. For questions and comments, contact us. info@blackhollywoodlive.com. Like us on Facebook, Twitter, tweet us or Instagram us at BHL Online. And I am the official voice of Black Hollywood Live, Scipio, Instagramming at KingXOBay. Thanks for tuning in.
Hollywood Redefined.
The views expressed here are those of the host only and do not necessarily reflect the views of BHL or its owners or principals.